So I'm gonna upgrade my handlebar from this to this. Now, without wasting any time, let's get going. Hello and welcome back to the channel, guys. Like as you saw from the title and the thumbnail, this video is all about me upgrading the handlebar of my bike. So I'm gonna upgrade my handlebar from this to this. Why do I need this upgrade? Well, there are a couple of things. First is that this handlebar is wider than the one I have already on my bike, which is the stock handlebar. Second thing is, this is like more towards me as compared to the stock handlebar, which is a little straight. If not 100% straight, it is a little straight as compared to this handlebar. The reason for me upgrading to this handlebar is it will improve my riding posture, as also this handlebar is wide. It will make my ride more comfortable as compared to this stock handlebar. So initially, when I started riding this bike, I didn't feel to upgrade or modify anything. But as in when I started to get used to it, it is when I realized that I'll need to make certain changes in my bike in order for me to make my ride more comfortable. Changes like adding these handlebar risers, or adding a top box on my bike, a top rack, adding, like, which is a basic necessity, the crash guard. That's my friend Roshan, and actually he bought this handlebar for me yesterday because the KTM service center is near to him. Coming to this handlebar, as I said, Roshan got this for me from the KTM service center. So well, this is a KTM 390 adventure bar. As you can see, it's written KTM over here. So now, without wasting any time, let's get going to the mechanic and let's install this handlebar. At first I thought that I would just go to my nearest service center of Royal Enfield and get the handlebar installed, but later I realized that it's a Sunday today and there's no way that the service center guys are gonna entertain me just for the purpose of installing a handlebar. Because if you must have experienced, any service center, you must have seen that on Sundays and on the weekends they are just like busy, like crazy busy. So that is the reason I changed my plan from going to a service center to just going to a local guy to get the installation done. And I'm going to Andheri. If you are from Mumbai, you must have seen that in Andheri, like near the Western Express Highway metro station, there are these shops who just purely work on adding accessories to the motorbikes. So I'm going to one of those shops to get this installed, because those guys are as experienced as the service center guys, because they have worked on ton of the bikes, like of multiple brands. So that is the reason I'm going there.
Thank you.
you see this Mahavir motorcycle, they are the guys who would help me install the handlebar. So let me just talk to the guy and come back to you.
So I've got my guy who is gonna help me installing the handlebar. I'm gonna show you the comparison between the stock handlebar and this KTM 390 Adventure handlebar. Now I like the default handlebar weight which comes with the bike. Now if this gets, you know, installed with the KTM 390 Adventure bike's handlebar, which I am very skeptical about, as the size is very different. Anyways, I have with me the weight which you have to get it separately. It is like one bar and weight costs you around 95 rupees. So on the KTM 390 Adventure handlebar, you'll have to drill this hole on the left side. As you see, there is no hole on the left side of the bar, it's just on the right side. So that is one more reason you need a professional's help in installing an aftermarket or a third party handlebar. He just took off the handlebars. This is the stock handlebar. Now I'll show you the comparison between the KTM 390 Adventure handlebar and the stock handlebar of my Himalayan. The front one is the stock handlebar and the back one is the 390 Adventure handlebar. You can see the difference. First, how wide it is, the KTM 390 Adventure bar. And second, you will be able to see it better from here. If I have to show you guys like this, you can see the cowl, the bend which the 390 Adventure handlebar has as compared to the stock handlebar, which is like almost as good as a straight handlebar. So these are the two major reasons for me to get a 390 Adventure handlebar installed. One change which has gone on to installing this new handlebar is the clutch cable. Now, because the handlebar is wider than the stock handlebar, we had to install a different clutch cable, that is the clutch cable of Thunderbird. So the Thunderbird's cable is a little thinner than the actual stock Himalayan's own clutch cable.
Well, the installation of my new handlebar is complete. And this is my old handlebar. Now it's time for first impressions. And man, oh man, this position, the wider handlebar, it all feels so commanding. I mean, It's just so awesome. I have never got such good riding experience before. This is just so amazing. The wider handlebar, it totally like changes your riding position, your stance, your posture, everything. It just makes your ride so damn comfortable. And I'm loving it. Now I just can't wait to go on a bike ride, which is gonna happen very soon. Well, that was the video, guys. If you liked it, if you enjoyed watching it, please hit the like button. And if you are new to the channel, please also subscribe and support the growth. With that said, I'm gonna end this video here. I'll see you in a video very soon where I'm planning a ride. So see you there. Till then, goodbye, take care, stay safe and stay tuned.